Do you know my mum? Tracy Beaker.
Morning!
You'll know her if you live on the Duke Estate. Everyone knows Tracy Beaker from Marlborough House.
Respect.
She even gets respect at Devonshire House.
Come on, Mum. This way.
You are speedy today, young lady. Come on, Jess, keep on. Hi. Walking dogs was easy. Let's go.
Woo! Woo!
Come on.
Hello,
hi. No, not in there. We'll get chicken later. Hi, Fred. Come on.
My mum knows everyone and she's done everything.
Hi, Bab.
Mommy,
come on.
She was a care worker, she sold cars, she did gardening, she ran a wine bar, and everyone called it Tracy's.
Thanks, Kim.
Even though that wasn't its name.
It's just a bit grey in here, Fred. You could just take a splash of colour. Think about it.
It's fine, Tracy.
Now she's a dog walker and a waitress and loads of other things too.
You're welcome. Or brown. Come on, dude.
She's always doing at least 3 jobs at once.
You're welcome. Come on, Fred. Oddie mates rates. Very reasonable.
We don't need redecorating. She'll have to move.
If the paying customers, I know.
You are tighter than 2 coats of paint, Fred. Thank you.
There you go.
Come on, Fred. How about a blue? Orange.
Me and Mum, we're a team. We do everything together. Some people think old stuff is just rubbish, but Mum taught me how to find hidden gems.
Careful with those.
Jess knows what she's doing. We're in here all the time, aren't we, Babs? Looking for priceless treasures to make our fortune. Mum, look. How much?
Seeing as it's you two.
When Mum was my age, she lived in a children's home. It had a proper name, but she only ever called it the dumping ground. All she wanted was to live with her mum in their own home, so I'm living my mum's dream. But my mum's story had a happy ending when she was adopted by my granny, Camilla Lawson, who's a real published writer.
I could imagine.
How do I know all this? Because my mum became a writer too. She wrote her own life story.
But I was determined to win, and nothing was going to stop me. Swallowing the worm was easy, but keeping it down was impossible. I threw up with the force of a volcano.
What happened to the worm?
Oh, it was fine. I saw it in a patch of vomit and it just wriggled away. And that is how I won the dare game. So I said to Justine Littlewood, you can just bog off.
I love helping my mum walk the dogs.
Bye, Jess. Have a good day. Love you.
We're not allowed to keep a dog in our flat, but Mum says one day we'll buy our own house.
And then we'll get a dog who can live with us forever. I believe her, because she always keeps her promises. She's strong and brave. She never ever cries. She only gets hay fever sometimes. But best of all, she's kind. And that's why my mum, Tracy Beaker, is the person I most admire.
Thank you, Jess. Excellent work. It's great to see you building up your confidence.
Yeah, but miss, she cheated.
I didn't.
You just wrote about your mum. Anyone could do that.
You couldn't.
Tyrone, the people we admire don't have to be famous. Sometimes they're people we know, people who inspire us to live our best life. So who inspires you the most?
Bruno Machine!
Thank you, Charlie. Very inspirational. Now, who's next?
Hey, Geeky Beaky. What are you reading?
Nothing. Get off.
Justine Littlewood was the meanest girl in the dumping ground.
Stop it!
Is this your mum's book? The one she wrote?
Just give it back. Let go.
Oh.
Now look what you've done.
Oh, my nose. Oh.
Tyrone?
There you go. Hello? What sort of accident? With who? How exactly? Anti-bullying policy.
Tyrone wasn't bullying Jess. If anything, he came off worse.
Don't you dare blame this on Jess. This happened on your watch and I hold you fully responsible.
It was just a nosebleed. It's all in the accident book.
He fainted! Poor Jess was terrified!
You won't tell anyone, will you?
You don't tell anyone my mum yelled at the teacher.
Why not? I wish my mum would.
I never liked it here anyway. I can't believe I trusted you with my daughter. I want a full investigation and someone should be sacked for this. Jess, go and wait outside.
Please, it wasn't Miss Oliver's fault.
You don't have to stand up for her.
I want to. She's nice, not like Miss Vomit Bagley.
Who?
My old school teacher. Look, if I'm being honest, me in school, we never really got on. And I just wanted things to be different for Jess.
They are.
Jess is a delightful student. It's a privilege to teach her.
Thank you. I'm sorry for kicking off.
You know, if you really want to work on your anger issues...
Excuse me, I do not have anger issues.
We all need to blow off steam sometimes. You know what I find helpful?
Knitting?
Kickboxing.
Kickboxing?
It's extremely cathartic and good exercise. Can recommend a beginner's class if you're interested.
Kickboxing.
Posh.
It's all right. Seem better.
Can I help you, madam? I'm here for kickboxing lessons.
You'll have to join first.
Okay.
Thank you. Oh, here goes him, millionaires.
Tracy Beaker.
I'm sorry, do I know you?
That's Sean Godfrey, the footballer.
Retired footballer. Done my knee in a few years back. Risked a game. You really don't remember?
I'm sorry, I'm not really into sport.
Think back. Empty house, cardboard furniture.
Oh, football? No way, you're football.
Of all the gyms in all the towns in all the world, she walks into mine. Come on.
You got that from a movie.
She's a smart one, chip off the old block.
You never said you knew Sean Godfrey.
I only knew him as football. We used to hang out.
Yeah, skipping school.
Which is very bad and you should never, never do it.
I wouldn't want to.
But all those years ago and I never knew your real name.
Well, I never forgot yours, Tracy Beaker. Hope you haven't paid anything yet. Your money's no good here. Hold on 1 second. I need you to sort Tracy out with the complimentary.
Does he own this place?
Looks like it.
You can bring your daughter, your husband. Lucky man.
He would be if he existed.
What about a boyfriend?
What about it?
That's great.
So, how do I look?
beautiful.
Thanks, Cam. Are you sure you're okay to sort out Jess's dinner?
Yeah. We're making muffins and then we're going to get fried chicken from the shop.
Ooh, sounds lovely. Maybe I'll just stay here.
No, this is our special time.
Fine, your granny can spoil your rotten, but tomorrow it's extra broccoli. See you later. Love you.
Love you too.
Have fun with Sean Godfrey.
She won't.
You've decided already, have you?
He's not Mum's type.
Ignore them, it's just Paps. Thank you, guys. All right, ladies. What are you drinking? Cristal? Dom Perignon? Mm-hmm. Types of champagne.
Yeah, I know. I used to manage a bar. I know how overpriced they are. Beer, please.
Me that too. I'll risk the carbs tonight, seeing as it's you. So, what'd you make of this place?
I can't believe people queue up and pay good money to get in here.
I don't. They'd pay me to drink in here if they had to. I get too many Premier League stars in here, you know?
I thought you didn't play football anymore.
Still. Everyone knows who I am.
Wish I did.
Is that Mum? What did she say about Sean Godfrey?
Sean Godfrey is a boring show-off with an ego the size of a football pitch. Oh dear.
57 minutes, a new record.
What about Tristan from the City?
1 hour 22. This is the fastest I've been yet.
Bye. My mum has very high standards. No man has ever been able to meet them yet.
Bye now.
There was the bank car, the bike car, and Blue, the skateboarder.
Please, Tracy. I really thought we had something here.
We did, and now we don't. Sorry. Bye. Bye now. Bye-bye. Bye.
I quite liked Blue. I even thought he might be the one.
She doesn't need the one. She's got us.
Absolutely. And cupcakes.
To the taxi rank around the corner to the left. Right. Thank you.
Tracy, you can't go yet. Leave it! I'm warning you. Tracy, please, what did I do?
Nothing. I just need to see my daughter.
Okay. Another day, then?
Look, I've got a lot going on in my life. I don't really have time for whatever this is.
Trace, it's me, one of your oldest friends.
If you say so.
Can't believe you don't remember.
I remember a kid called Football. He had a rough life and he was pretty rough himself. But at least he was real.
So I'm not real now?
Sean Godfrey's not real. He's just this big fake costume. But underneath that, somewhere, there's the same scared little boy. I just hope he's okay.
Tracy! Look, you're right. I was being fake. I see it all the time. People try to impress me because I'm a footballer. I did the same thing to you because you're Tracy Beaker. And I've always wanted you to like me, but I just never knew how. Please, don't go home. Let's try again.
Only if I get to choose where we go.
Sure.
This
ready to kiss him.
What?
I saw you from the balcony with Sean Godfrey.
Well, you should have been in bed asleep.
So should you. You said you hated him.
I never said that. I mean, Sean's a bit of a show-off, but he's okay. I think you'll really like him.
You're going to see him again?
If that's okay with you.
Mum, he's not the one, is he?
Don't ask me. What do I know? I thought your dad was the one.
Sorry, you'd always have a girlfriend. I know. Just be careful. I don't want you to get hurt.
Why is that funny?
Because I'm the mum. I'm supposed to look after you, okay?
Remember, nobody hurts the Beaker girls.
That's it. Good girl, Tracy. Keep you focused. Three. Wouldn't want to be that guy. Four. Five. So you don't want to go? You can imagine it's my face.
No, thank you.
What are you playing?
It's not a game.
That is the dog's phone. You girls thinking of getting a dog?
One day.
I'm just looking.
Which one's your favourite?
Dogs aren't toys. They are a very serious commitment.
It's Alfie. Alfie is her favourite. Jess, show him.
OK. That's Alfie.
He's a cute little fella. Says he's good with children.
Yes, but we're not allowed dogs in our flat.
This time, Sean really wants to show you his house.
But this is not another boring, fancy restaurant.
Jess Beaker, Sean has paid for all these really lovely, expensive meals. At the very least, you could just try to make an effort, OK?
Hey, gorgeous girl. Hey, Jess.
Hello, Sean Godfrey.
Can you show us how to do those tricks?
It takes a lot of practice and training. You know I have a youth coaching session at my gym?
How much does that cost?
Free. To friends of Jess.
Yep, that's me. My best mate.
Can I have a selfie for my mum? You were her favourite.
Was I?
And me, I want one for my dad.
OK, yes. Go on. Yes. Let's go over here, let's go over here.
OK.
Let's go. Who's first?
Me. Yeah.
OK.
OK.
Oh, go on. You take it.
OK.
Who's next? Let's go.
Thank you.
No worries.
You all right?
You tell me a thing as we're best mates, you liar.
I didn't lie.
You know you did. We're not friends.
Well, I want to be friends.
With me or with stupid, strong old Frey?
Yeah, that's good. Thank you.
Nice, man.
Right. You don't like him?
No.
Why not?
He talks about football all the time, and he's always making us go for meals and stupid days out, like a family.
Nightmare. Somebody call the feds.
There you go.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
No problem, no problem. There you go.
Come on, Jess, come over.
There you go. All right, no worries.
Thanks so much.
What was Cameron saying to you?
We were just talking. It's okay, my mate. Thanks. Is this your house?
Yeah. Come on in.
Big?
Empty.
The house was always a mess when I was a kid. I like it like this.
It's minimalist, very classy.
Where's all your stuff?
Watch out, boss lady's here.
That's right, don't you forget it. Hello, Jess, I'm Rosalie. I'm the housekeeper.
Don't you keep your own house?
I'd like to see that.
No, I just live here. Rosalie's in charge of this place, including me.
Afternoon tea will be served at 4 p.m. sharp. Don't let my scones go cold.
Thanks, Rosalie.
I got a bit of work to do, so, do you Beaker girls want to chill out in the pool?
You've got a pool? We didn't bring our costumes.
I did.
Sean Godfrey's really lucky.
So are we. dream.
Yeah.
Imagine if we could stay here always, and we never had to go back to that pokey little flat.
But it's our home. Mum, we are going home, aren't we? Tell me we're going home. Mum!
When I was your age, I spent my whole life moving around. I've always tried to protect you from that.
So, why do you want to move now?
Well, things have changed.
Because of Sean Godfrey.
Well, yes, but it's not all about him. It's about what's best for us. You. I mean, don't you want to live in a mansion?
Hello. I didn't know you had a dog.
Don't you recognise him?
Alfie!
It's official. Bassie checked everything out and said that Alfie can live here with Sean. And if you'd like, so can we.
We thought you'd be pleased.
Alfie's gonna love it here. He's got this huge garden. He can go out running with Sean every day.
Your mum's always said you've wanted a dog.
Stop telling me what I want!
Jess? We shouldn't have sprung it on you like that. We just wanted it to be a wonderful surprise.
Alfie was a wonderful surprise. It's just everything else.
The mansion, the pool, the home cinema.
I mean, Sean Godfrey.
I know. He's okay, really, you know, Jess.
You really like him, don't you, Mum?
Yeah, I really do. Just wish you did. And I could give you a proper start in life.
What do you mean we've got the best life?
We know that. It's the way people talk about this estate. I just want you to do better than I did.
Sean, your guests are here.
How long do I have to stay here?
We agreed. One dinner, one film, and you promised to give Sean a chance.
Girls, come through. We're having steak and chips, my favourite.
Don't.
Alfie! Alfie!
So good. Come on, Jess, eat up.
Mine's not cooked, it's bleeding.
That's because it's rare.
Shall I just pop it back in the pan for a bit?
And lose all the flavour. Looks like I need to teach you girls of the finer things in life.
And if you don't like it, just eat the chips.
Chips. That's all I ever got to eat when I was a kid. I would have killed for a big, fat, juicy steak just like that. Try it, just one bite.
Yeah, just one bite, Jess. It's not a lot to ask. So, how did training go today? Is Tyrone still your biggest fan?
Are you feeding my prime fillet steak to the dog?
I don't like it. Why can't Alfie have it?
He didn't even try it. Get down, Alfie!
Stop that!
I didn't hurt him.
Yes, you did, you great big stupid bully!
You do not speak to me like that.
You don't get to tell me what to do!
Are you gonna let her get away with that?
Yes, I am. She's right. No one gets to tell the Beaker girls what to do. Come on, Jess.
Sean's not a bad man. He just loses his temper sometimes.
Yeah, that's not all he's lost.
Shall I call you a taxi?
No, it's okay. We'll walk.
Used to drive.
She never actually had one. It was all in my imagination.
Well, this one's yours.
Well, I don't want it. Well, of course I want it, but I need you to respect me and my daughter.
I do respect you.
Then stop trying to buy us.
I'm not. I just wanted to give you a present. Because I love you. I love you.
Can we go now?
Stay. I'm begging you.
Sean, stop.
I wanted to surprise you. Look, Trace, Jess. I'm sorry it all went wrong. It's all my fault.
Stop it, you idiot. You're gonna get all muddy.
I deserve it. I'm a clumsy idiot. But I wanna be better. You make me better.
Only you can do that, Sean.
I'm trying. Please, if you'll let me.
Okay, just get up before you ruin your trousers.
Tracy Beaker.
No way. You have got to be joking.
Mum.
I've never been more serious about anything in my life. Tracy, I know I've made a lot of mistakes. And I know I don't deserve you. But if there's one thing I'm sure of, Tracy, it's that I love you more than anything in the world. I'd do anything for you, Trace. Anything. So, Tracy Beaker, will you marry me?
Like I said, me and my mum, Tracy Beaker, are a team. We look after each other and we don't need anyone else. And we definitely don't need Sean Godfrey.